Daryl Brugink with No Till Farmer. I'm here with Jim Bass of Dawn Equipment, and I want to talk a little bit about a couple new things that you guys have done, some updating or some new things you've done with Curvetine and also with RFX. So why don't we start with Curvetine, Jim? Tell me what are the improvements, the upgrades you've made to that, what's different about it from before?
Well, Curvetine's been very successful and very widely accepted in a wide variety of tillage conditions. It's not just a no-till tool. And as we get more and more of them out, we've been casting it as a ductile iron piece. We use teak and tapered roller bearings compared to the sealed roller bearing that's standard in most other products, most other companies' products. The Timken tapered roller bearings are actually outlasting the teeth. So what we've done is we've separated, we've kept our same Timken bearing hub arrangement and gone to a forged heat-treated circular ring, which is replaceable. And it actually, because of the forging process, lasts longer in many abrasive soil conditions. And it also gives us the ability to add spacers in so you can more easily adjust the spacing from the center line for shallow planted crops like cotton or soybeans if you want to get it closer, or corn a little bit further out. The ideal distance center to center on our Curvetine, and most closing wheels, and most people aren't aware of this, but center to center at the tightest point should be about the same as your seat depth, ideally. So improved wear characteristics, more replaceable, but another advantage is now that they're two-piece, you can actually have a variety of different options. If somebody wants a rubber tire, we have a rubber tire that can be rolled into the same pump. Because as planters get wider, okay, you've got, let's say on a 24-row planter, 24-row 30, you've got 48 closing wheels, you've got 96 bearings on the back of that planter. And if one of those bearings goes out, you have to stop. And what is the cost of spraying when the sun's shining and stopping a 60-foot planter until you can go find a replacement closing? It's expensive, much more than the cost of that wheel. So we find people really like our reusable Timken bearing hub with the triple lip seal, same one we've used on our trash wheels for years. And just as a reliability issue, if nothing else.
Let's talk about the RFX. We came out with that, I think, a couple of years ago. And it works in concert with your road cleaners. Tell us a little bit about what the RFX is, what it does, and then what improvements you came to that as well.
Right. Well, the RFX is a kind of a natural development from our very successful GFX, remotely adjusted hydraulic rotor. I mean, there is, it's amazing to be with a guy when you install the GFX for the first time, and he turns the knob and sees the pressure change, and he says, you mean I don't need to crawl under that planter anymore? And this is an exciting time to be in agriculture. There's so much going on these days, and we're going to more and more precision on everything. You look at the GPS, the auto steering. But planters have been kind of lagging behind the development. Well, it's starting from itself, where we can, especially a $7 car, it's worth doing a good job of planting. The planting operation is the most important operation of the year. You look around this show, and none of this is any good. All this equipment, these bins behind us, if you don't have a good stand of seedlings. So that planter is the most important piece of equipment. And so the RFX now is a natural offshoot of the GFX, and it allows you to adjust the row unit down pressure so you're not this good enough. Now, springs, the traditional springs, the downforce varies enormously from the bottom of the parallel link travel to the top of the parallel link travel, because as the spring stretches, the force changes. Airbags, which progress beyond that, are a natural improvement because the air pressure is somewhat, air is compressible and is somewhat constant, so they have a more constant down pressure through the range of motion. But the downside to air pressure is air is compressible. And you take a 24-row or a 32 or 36-row planter, and you see a soft spot up there and you want to make a change to it. It takes a long time to change that, make a significant change in the downforce. Okay? With the GFX and now the RFX, we are hydraulic, not air. Hydraulic oil is not compressible. Okay? So it responds instantly to changes in the cab of down pressure. So RFX, and it includes an integral cumin. So it's not like when you hit a rock, you have to push oil back into the tractor. It just goes back and forth between the accumulator that you can see on the integral cumin, which we have as a patent feature of the unit. So the RFX is kind of a natural progression from the controllability of the row cleaner to controllability of the row cleaner.
We should talk around this precision thing, because I know you guys are working this direction. Came out Farm Progress Show with the new design for precision. And it's really all about gauging the field conditions and your rowing being conditions instantaneously. Just tell us a little bit about that and where you stand on that.
Well, my son Joe is really doing a good job in this area, and his team, his development team, and they've come up with a ground hardness sensing system, which is actually based off the patent that I did on our old paradigm that I introduced 20 years ago. But he's really taken it far beyond there and improved it. And we want to actually sense the ground hardness out in front of the unit. So by sensing it in front of the planter, and with a quick reacting hydraulic system, we can actually adjust the downforce on the row cleaner and the row unit before we get to the wet spot, rather than after. You know, the existing sensors that are on the market right now rely on downforce that is gauged on the planter closing unit. Well, they're behind where the seat is going. And the other thing is you're moving, this is not stationary, we're moving at 5 or 6 miles an hour. So Joe has the system set up where the ground hardness sensing system out in front can react fast enough at normal planting speeds to change the down pressure on the unit so that you're anticipating, you're ready for it when you hit that wet spot. And this really makes a big difference. We've got fields with heat on one end and clay on the other, you know, and guys right now have been changing the RFX and the GFX manually, but we're leading towards the next step with automatic control.
My understanding is we're doing a lot more R&D on it, and hopefully by support team, hopefully we're going to launch it.
We'll see how it goes. Okay, we've got units out, and we'll see how it goes.
That's exciting stuff.
Oh, it is fun. It's just an exciting time, and we're just very fortunate, I think, that it's in the ag business also, too. And I want to thank you very much for what you do for the industry.
So. Well, I appreciate it. Again, I'm Daryl Brugink with No-Till Farmer with Jim Bassett from Don. Thank you for joining us.